Hey guys, welcome back to NerdCrave. So I wanted to take an opportunity tonight to just discuss my journey into the world of anime. I had a viewer ask me a couple of days ago to comment on anime because I do mention anime on my channel, but I haven't really done an awful lot of anime content. So now really just felt like the right time responding to that comment. So here we go. So I just want to start off by saying I am not one of these, you know, insane, crazy anime fans. I am fairly young to the world of anime. Of course, as a lot of people my age, I was exposed to certain things back in the day, in the late 80s and early 90s, stuff like Sailor Moon, Gem and the Holograms, things like that, that you know, gave me a taste and feel for what I could expect out of Japanese animation, but I wasn't really considering them to be much different than anything else that I watched at the time until I got into the late 90s and I saw for the first time the movie Akira. Now, I was on kind of a kick in the late 90s, discovering all kinds of really, you know, highbrow science fiction, things like 2001 A Space Odyssey and A Clockwork Orange and things like that, a lot of Kubrick stuff. When I came across Akira, I felt like I had discovered something that was absolutely on the level of anything that someone like Stanley Kubrick would have created. It was absolutely just so dark and disturbing and yet vivid. The stories were so deep and complex. You have to watch Akira like 5 times at least in order to even really understand what's going on in that movie. I just absolutely loved it. You compare something like Akira to even the movie The Matrix, and like there's a parody there. Like, sure, it's animation, but it's so really, really good. And so a lot of my earlier experiments with anime surrounded movies more than TV shows, and I've consumed a lot of the Studio Ghibli stuff. You can see behind me here I've got a VHS copy of Kiki's Delivery Service. I've got a really nice Blu-ray box set of Princess Mononoke. Absolutely, absolutely love these movies. They're so beautifully drawn, so classically, just the stories are fantastic. I can't say enough great things about Studio Ghibli and some of the things. Castle in the Sky, for one, is an absolute favorite of mine. And that's really how I consumed anime up until about 2014 or 2015, was when I really started dabbling in the TV shows. And I actually bought my son season 1, I believe it was season 1 and season 2, of an anime called Claymore. I knew nothing about it. I bought it just based on the cover art. I sat down and watched it with him, and it was just absolutely gorgeous. I've since discovered that I don't really like that sort of dark, gritty, sort of ultra-violent anime. That's not really my cup of tea. I'm not the biggest fantasy anime guy. I do prefer the science fiction themes over the fantasy for the most part, but that's not exclusive. There are definitely many exceptions to the rule. But going back to Claymore was beautifully drawn, and it exposed me to that whole kind of demon hunter, demon slayer trope that's a really a big thing in anime that I had previously not really been familiar with. And I watched that whole show with my son, and I absolutely loved it. I definitely, like, I go back and watch it every couple of years just because that was kind of me dipping my toes, if you will, into the world of anime. And from there, you know, I didn't go crazy with it. I absolutely do particularly appreciate the artwork and often the music in a lot of anime. But more recently now, in the last couple of years, I have been moving towards stuff like I started last year with Dragon Ball Z, and then, I picked up these DVD box sets of Dragon Ball GT, but absolutely love Dragon Ball Z. Now, are there things to criticize about it? Yeah, obviously, the original Saiyan Saga, there's an awful lot of filler footage in there, there's an awful lot of things, you know, repeat stuff, a lot of the, you know, the memes of, you know, everybody powering up, and it's all like, ah, 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 you know, it's on and on and on. I would, you know, I would really like to be able to consume that story with all that crap cut out, because what's left of each episode is probably about 7 minutes out of 20 that's actual new content, relevant content. But I absolutely love the world of Dragon Ball Z, and I actually went out and bought Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, the new RPG game, on my Xbox One, because I do absolutely love the world of Dragon Ball Z. And then more recently, on a recommendation from another YouTuber that I follow, Happy Console Gamer, I started to get into the kind of giant robot thing, and that, I've really discovered, is where my heart and soul absolutely lies with anime. I absolutely love the Gundams and the Macrosses of the world. I just recently finished Macross Frontier. You can see my screensaver on the laptop here, Ranka Lee. I have never enjoyed an anime as much as I enjoyed Macross Frontier, and I'm really looking forward to going back to the original Hyperdimension Fortress Macross, whatever, the absolute original one, and watching that now, because, you know, I had such a great time with Frontier. And the coolest thing about Frontier is that whole aspect of the music and the way they wove the music into the action scenes and made the music integral to the plot. In other words, the singing of the two girls, Ranka and Cheryl, was actually effective in the battle sequences, in terms of it actually had an effect on the turn of battle. Absolutely awesome concept, and I can't say enough about that. So, like, I'm a huge fan. I've also recently been watching Bubblegum Crisis, which I love to pieces. That whole kind of, you know, concept of rogue AIs or rogue robots super interests me. And again, like I said, I absolutely prefer the sci-fi stories over the fantasy stories, although I don't dislike the fantasy stories. I just really feel more drawn towards those sci-fi stories. And the stuff with the future tech, the, you know, the flight suits, the mech suits, the, you know, armor and all the cool weapons and stuff like that, it just really gets me going. So that's kind of where I've been. I've been dabbling with a few other series that are on Netflix. There are some, I guess, that don't really fall into I don't know if they're real anime or whether they're American anime, but I've been enjoying The Dragon Prince, I think it's called, on Netflix. That's a nice fantasy story. Also, the Ni No Kuni movie that came out on Netflix was really great. I'm a huge fan of Ni No Kuni. And there's a lot of bleed over between anime and Japanese role-playing games. The art styles are very similar. Oftentimes, manga or anime will be based on the video games, or the video games will be based on a manga or anime. So there's a lot of interplay there, and I absolutely, definitely enjoy all those themes. I almost exclusively play JRPGs for my video gaming, except for a little bit of platforming here and there, just to break things up. But anyways, guys, that really gives you an idea of my journey with anime. I'm moving forward into the Gundam series. I'm going back and catching up on the Macross series and getting into things like Cowboy Bebop and what's the other one? Neon Genesis Evangelion. I have watched Death Note, and I really love that, and I'm probably going to go back and watch that again. So that just really gives you a perspective on where I'm coming from with anime. Anime, for me, just like everything else on my channel, is about the stories. If you've seen my channel trailer, I talk about how important stories are to me, and that's absolutely the case. Anytime that there is great writing and great artwork to tie it together with great music, I am there with bells on. I am absolutely ready to consume anything that you suggest. So by all means, sound off in the comments and let me know, because I am still what I would consider an anime noob. So sound off in the comments. Let me know, what are your favorite animes, and particularly, what are your favorite sci-fi based animes, because that's really what interests me. And before you leave, click the like button if you would. It really helps out a ton. It really does make a difference to a young channel. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. By all means, I'm putting up at least a couple videos a week. I do appreciate it. Anyways, guys, stay classy.